From the evening, I remember. Thank you for attending tonight's seminar. Today we will talk about the preview of technical analysis. My name is Jessie Dean. Okay, so let's start our class. This is the STI index. So firstly, let's see the STI monthly chart. Recently, we know that the market went up sharply, right? And the upward breaks through the previous high point. Okay, this is the STI monthly chart. This is the one candlestick stand for 1 month. Okay, this is the monthly chart. So we know that where is the big resistance? This is the box. So if the price can upward break through the box, it means that we can catch some good opportunity. Okay, so let's see this one. Next one, let's take a look, let's see the 10 years change probability and statistics of STI index. Okay, this is the rising possibility, the falling possibility, the consolidation possibility. Okay, this is the January, February, March. So we can see the market is now is in July, right? Okay, so we can see July, the rising possibility is 0.7, the falling possibility is 0.1. So what's that meaning? It means that the market is good in this month. Okay, so if you want to catch some good profit, you'd better buy and keep stocks in this month. Okay, then we can see next one. August. The rising possibility is 0.1. The falling possibility is 0.8. So what's the meaning? So it tells us that from the chart we know the market in August is not good. So if you want to buy some stocks, you'd better catch profit in this month. But next month, you should prepare to sell. Then we can see this is the September. The rising possibility is 0.6. The falling possibility is 0.4, which means that August, the September, the market is also good. Then this is the October, November, and December. So from the chart, we can know that which month is good. Okay, so you should remember, if you want to buy some stocks, this month is good. Okay, so let's see the chart first. This is the STI index. So we know that here, today, the price upward breaks through the previous high point. So where is the next resistance? This one, right? Okay, so we can know that the market is very good, and recently so many strong stocks. So how to find strong stocks? I can teach you one good method, and I hope if you are holding member, you can learn this method to find some strong stocks. Okay, so firstly, let's click the Singapore market. Then we can see all Singapore stocks. Then if you can find some high volume stock, you also can find some high accuracy stocks. Okay, then firstly, you should click Singapore market. Then this is the all Singapore stocks. Then we can click save. Maybe we can key the name is S, then click save. Okay, then we can click market, then click sector browse, click extract, then we can find the S, the fire. Okay, so this is the steps. Then we can change the data range. I want to know in this month which stock is strong. Then we can click this one, change the data range, then click OK. if we finish this step, then we can right click the percentage, then we analyze the stocks one to one, okay? So firstly, this stock, let's analyze this stock first. Okay, so this stock is very strong, right? Last time I taught you a good method. I don't know whether you can remember or not. This method is like this. If you see the big candlestick, big bullish candlestick, and all high volume, right? So which point is the good buy point? Half of the candlestick, right? So every day you can check the stocks. If the price touch the half of the candlestick, what should we do? We'd better buy this stock. But if you buy this stock, you'd better set stop loss point first. Okay, so if you buy, then you can catch some good opportunity. Okay, then if you have this stock, how to judge whether this stock still has chance or not? Okay, so we can know these days the stock is went up strongly. Then we can see this stock. This is the volume. The next day the price dropped, right? But we can see the volume decrease. So it tells us that in the future, the stock is still have chance to go up. Okay, then we can see this one. If you still catch this stock, if you still have hold this stock, so which point is the first sell point? Maybe here. Why here is the first sell point? Because we can see this is the candlestick, right? This is the half of the candlestick. It's the first resistance. If the price can upward break through, then we should know. Maybe the next point is here, okay? Then this is the first one, these strong stocks. Then we can see this one. This stock is good or not? Okay, then we can see this stock. So today, the price for a fair little. Okay, then we can see the volume. The volume decrease. So, which means that it still have chance to go up. But where is the good buy point? So we can see next one. This stock is good or not? It's so strong stock, right? Okay, then how to find it? So from this period, last time I taught you volume is very important, okay? So we can see this stock, the big volume, right? And the big bullish candlestick, which means that big money start to operate this stock. Okay, then we can see next day, which point is the good buy point? Half of the candlestick, right? So here, maybe you have another chance to buy. Then we can see if you key the price about half of the candlestick. So here, you can buy or not. You can get in. You can buy successfully. Okay, then if you buy, you can earn some good profit recently, right? Okay, so this is the next stock. This is the strong stock. Then we can see this one. This stock is good or not? It's also strong, right? We can see the trend is very good. Then if you see this stock, but if you didn't buy this stock, we should know where is the good buy point. But for now, there's no good buy point, right? Okay, then we can see next one. If you want to find some strong stocks, you can use this method, okay? Then we can see this stock. If you still hold this stock, so we can see this one. This is the big bullish candlestick and the high volume, right? Okay, so which price is the good buy point? Is the good price to get in? Half, right? So we can see here, half of the candlestick, so it's the good buy point. Then if you have this stock, if you already bought this stock, you still can hold or not. Then we can see here, if you still have this stock, which point is the first resistance? So maybe here is the resistance, okay? Then we can see next one. This dog is so strong, right? Then we can see this one is also strong. Half of the candlestick is here. Then half of the candlestick. Half of the candlestick is here. Then you also can make some good profit. So we can see this dog. This dog is so strong. And we can see the volume. Check by the volume. The price went up and the volume increased. So good or not? It's good, right? Okay, then we can see next one. We can see this dog. This dog is called CNMC. So why we find this dog? Because we can see here. This from the chart, this is the wave one, right? The wave two. If you learned wave theory before, I taught you again. Then you can see here. If the price go up, then this is the wave one, then wave two, then wave three, wave four, and the wave five. Okay, then we can see this start. We can regard this period as wave one. This is the wave two. This is the wave three, right? But we from this tier, this price, we don't know whether we should sell or not. Then we can see next day. The price start to correct, right? Okay, then we can see the volume. The volume decrease or increase? Decrease, which means that this is the short-term correction, okay? Then where is the next buy point? Then we can see this candlestick. So last time I showed you, if the price go up, then volume increase is the good, good situation, right? Okay, then price drop, volume decrease. It's normal correction. Then this day the volume increase again and the price go up again. What's that meaning? Maybe have another chance to go up, right? So if you know how to judge the relation between price and volume, it's very important. It's very helpful for your investment. Okay. So this is the strong stocks. If you don't know how to find some strong stocks, you can use this method to focus on some strong stocks. Then you can find good opportunity to get in to buy again. Then we can see the market. This is the market. So we can see the chart. So firstly, we can use the trend line to judge whether the trend is good or not. This is the first high point. The next high point. Okay, then we can draw the trend line. We can connect the high point to another high point. Okay, so this is the downtrend line, right? Then if we connect this high point to this high point, so what's that meaning? If you already drew the trend line, then if you see that, we know that if you we can see how to judge the trend line is effective or not. At least the 3 points touch the trend line, right? Okay, then we can see this one. This is the first point, the next point. Then we know that the trend line can help us to judge the resistance and support. Okay, then we can see the price, the market, rebound, then touch the trend line. So what's that meaning? So tomorrow, tomorrow is very important for us. If the price cannot upward break through the trend line, which means that you'd better sell for short term to avoid some short-term risk. But for the, I already told you that in July the market is good, right? Okay, then if you didn't buy some stocks recently, then if the price touch the resistance and have some correction, then if the price drop here, then you have another chance to get in, okay? So if tomorrow the market can upward break through, maybe it's good. So you should remember, this is very important for us. Then we can use golden section to judge, okay? We can use, this golden section can help us to judge the space. So we can see here. This golden section can help us to judge where's the resistance and support, okay? Then we can see next one. This one is called homely. This one. Then we can use this one to judge where is the turning point, okay? The timing for turning point. Okay, then we know that we should find the low point or high point. This is the low point. The lowest point, we should see the low price. Okay, then this is the first candlestick. We know that 7 and times 7 is very important. So we can connect this low point. Then calculate. This is the 1. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then this is the low point. We can connect to another low point. Another low point is here, right? Okay, so we can know that if the price touch the line, which means that this is the timing for turning point, okay? So we know that where is the next turning point. So here, then this is another turning point. So if the price just touch the turning point, you'd better pay more attention, okay? So this is the market. You can use this method because this is for timing. For judging the timing turning point, okay?
So not Fibonacci.
Not Fibonacci.
So what is that?
This one is called, it's when you use the, this one is called only time window.
How do you use that?
You can connect the low point to another low point, or another high point to another high point, okay? Then you can judge where is the turning point. So we know, so we see here, the price just touch this one, then you know that this is the turning point. You'd better wait and see, and you should pay more attention, okay?
So you want the vertical line?
Yeah, the vertical line.
Means the, if the price just touch the vertical line, which means this is the turning point, okay? The timing. So you know that when is the next turning point, you can use this method to judge. Okay, then let's continue. This is the support and resistance of STI weekly chart. This is for the weekly chart, okay? Then you should remember this is the point. So if you see here, this is the line, right? Why I mark here? Because this is the high point, right? This is the low point. So we should pay more. We should mark this high point, the previous high point and low point. Then this is the next one. So we know that here. Recently, the weekly chart just here, touched here, right? So the next resistance point is here, 2882. Okay. Then the next one is 2998. So you should pay more attention. If the price can upward break through this resistance, maybe the next resistance is here, okay? So we can see the main contents of today's course. The first one is who should you trust? The next one, classical analytical methods in stocks. The third one, wrong investment thought of investors. The first one, establish the correct investment philosophy. The last one, who should you define? Okay, then we can see this, the first one, who should you trust? The first one you should ask yourself, who is right in the stock market? Is it your friend or you need to get some news from the newspaper? The next one, who to believe in the stock market? You should believe yourself or believe your friends. Then the next one, who will not lie to you in the stock market? So why we should believe ourselves? Because we need to learn some practical methods. Then if we grasp the trading system, we can use this trading system to make some good profit, right? Okay, so firstly, you should ask yourself, who should you trust in the stock market? Then next one, classical analytical methods in stocks. Because we know that there are two classical analytical methods in stocks. The first one is fundamental analysis. The next one is technical analysis. Because most of people are our members, so we know that we mainly use technical analysis to analyze our stocks. So firstly, let's see the fundamental analysis. The first one, the fundamental analysis is mainly research or company's financial data, forecasting market changes and assess the future profitability to grasp the price trends. The first one, macroeconomic analysis, central decision, the industry analysis, prospects, the analysis of financial condition of listed companies, statement. So you need to research so many data that you can get the good decision. Then the next one, the basic requirement of fundamental analysis, comprehensive, timely, and accurate. So because we read newspaper every day, right? So if you read newspaper, you can get the news, right? So maybe some analysis recommend some stocks. Then if you follow this news, is timely or not? It's not timely, right? Okay, the next one, conclusion. Individual stocks do not have this capability. Therefore, this method is not suitable for individual investors. So if you want to catch some, because we are all individual investors, if we want to make some good profit, we'd better use fundamental analysis to judge us. We'd better not use fundamental analysis. Okay. Then we can see next one. Why we should use technical analysis to judge our stocks? The first one, technical analysis, research the historical data by mathematical and statistical methods, thereby grasp the current market trends. Note, a full system security analysis is actually a probability analysis. So we can see the first one. The definition of technical analysis, to grasp future price trends and judge the future market behavior according to the chart. So if you use technical analysis to analyze, you should use chart. The next one, four elements of analysis. A, the price changes, the formation of difference in price. The next one, trend, the direction of price movements. The next one, chart, graphical pattern. The next one, market behavior, price changes. The market behavior, generative price changes. So conclusion, this method is simple, easy to learn, and quick to take effect. Okay, so why we should use technical analysis? Because we don't know when to buy, when to sell. So if we know how to use technical analysis, we can know when to buy, when to sell. So the next one, the trend is the core of technical analysis. Trend is the direction of the market. Because this is the first course of technical analysis, so maybe you think it's a little boring, but I think this is the basic knowledge, okay? The next one, trend scale. Long-term trend, medium-term trend, and the short-term trend. The long-term trend, more than 1 year. If you see the price trend. Maybe the price went up at least for at least 1 year. So this is the long-term trend, long-term uptrend. Then next one is medium-term trend. Medium-term trend is over 3 weeks. We can call this wave. The next one, short-term trend. Less than 10 days, usually less than 6 days. So if you buy some stocks, you'd better keep for long term or medium term or short term. Short term, right? Because the market ups and downs. So we'd better keep for short term trend. Less than 10 days. You'd better remember, less than 10 days. If you want to do short term investment, you'd better hold at less than 10 days. Usually less than 6 days, which also known as daily fluctuation. It does not have research value, okay? So conclusion, the majority of investors can make profit in the bull market. So we should buy and keep stocks in the bull market. The next one, only a small number of professional investors make profit in the secondary rebound of bear market. The next one, no research value in daily fluctuation. This is the basic knowledge. Then we can see next one, wrong investment sort of investors. The first one, excessive focus on fundamental while few analyses. So the conclusion is not comprehensive, timely, and accurate. So if you want, maybe some investors like to use fundamental analysis to judge stocks. So if you do few analysis, it's not good. You cannot get the comprehensive, timely, and accurate conclusion. The next one, see the real-time chart seriously affect the mentality of investors, because we know that if you see the real-time chart, ups and downs, up and downs, right? The next one, listening to stock analysis and news, read the newspaper. So this is the wrong investment sort of investors, okay? Next one, frequent trading to increase the transaction cost. Because if we see the real-time chart, it will increase our trading times, right? So because we know that one buy point, you need to pay commission, right? Then sell, you also need to pay the commission to the brokers. So if you buy two times, sell two times in 1 day, it's not good. You can pay so many commission. Then you can calculate. If you invest 100,000 and trade once a week, so then you can calculate the commission fee. So how much you will pay to the broker? So why we cannot see the real-time chart? This is the key factor, okay? Then we can see next one. Wrong investment sort. This is the chart. So we can imagine this is our stocks. And this is the price. Maybe we buy, this is the $10, the $12. So if we buy we buy at $10, then we keep. Then if the price up to $12, will you sell or not? Maybe you tell you. Or many people, many investors said, they will sell, but. Maybe in your mind, you will sell or not. You will think that I should earn more. I want to earn more, so I will not sell. Then if you don't sell, the price start to go down. Okay. So if the price go down, then this is the price maybe $4 to $10 again. Will you sell or not? Of course you will not sell, right? Because you cannot earn money. Here you earn money, you didn't sell. Why you should sell here? Then the price drop to $9, to $8, to $7, to $6, right? So you will buy and keep stocks in the downtrend, because if you earn money, you never sell. Then if you lose money, of course you will not sell, right? Okay, then the price start to go up again, but start to go up to $7 because you buy at $10, right? Then you, so we see here, the $7, then go up to $8, to $9, to $10, then will you sell or not? You will sell, right? Because you can see here, this, if you buy at $10, then the price drop to $6, then go up to $10 again. Will you keep or not? Obviously, many investors will sell because it's difficult. Then if you sell, then the price start to drop, start to go up. So we can see you always sell stocks in the uptrend, okay? So this is the wrong investment thought. Then we can see next one. Hatching law. Generally, the downtrend will be formed when the price drop around 10% from the top. So if you see the price, the shares drop around 10% from the top, you know that this is the downtrend. The downtrend will be formed. So you should prepare to sell. Okay. Then, however, the uptrend will be formed when the price rise around 10% from the bottom. You know that this is the bottom area. Okay. Then the uptrend will be formed. If the uptrend will be formed, you'd better buy, right? You'd better catch some good profit. So you should remember, if the price drop around 10%, you'd better from the top, you'd better sell. Then if the price rise around 10% from the bottom, you'd know that this is the good chance, okay? So this is the $12. If the price drop here, then go up. So where is the good buy point? So here is the low point, here is another one. You should increase your position, okay? Then if the price is in the uptrend, we'd better buy and increase our position. Then we can see next one. If you sell here, then you can buy in the uptrend. Then when the price drop, so we see here, this is the top, right? Then if the price drop around 10%, what should we do? Yeah. We'd better sell because this is the downtrend. The downtrend will be formed. So we'd better sell, okay? So you should remember, you can use this method to analyze your stocks, okay? If your stock rise around 10% from the bottom, you can buy. You can catch some good profit. If your stocks drop around 10% from the top, you'd better sell quickly, okay? Then how to establish the correct investment philosophy? The first one, adjust the relation between you and the market, complying with the law of market trends. The next one, follow index first, stock next, long-term first, short-term next to analyze your stocks. So what's the index first, stock next? Okay, then I can teach you this good method. And I think this method is very helpful for judging the share is strong or not. Firstly, we know that this is our philosophy, long-term first, short-term next, operate for million. Okay, so firstly, we should click chart, then click chart comparison. So we know we can compare the individual stocks to the SDI index. So if the share is stronger than index, you'd better keep. But if your stocks is weaker than index, you'd better sell, okay? So how to analyze? So firstly, let's see this stock. This stock is called Jumbo. Long time, last month, long time ago, I posted this stock on my Facebook. I don't know whether you can catch or not. So around this price, so why I posted this stock on my Facebook? Because we know that the price just upward breaks through the previous high point, create a new high, right, on high volume. So this is a good point to focus on, okay? Then if the price drop, then you can buy some stocks. Okay, then we can see this stock is strong or not. So we can compare it. Then we can see here, the price, the market drop, but the price job or not? Go up, right? What's that meaning? It means that the share is stronger than index, so we'd better buy this stock, right? So you can see stronger than index. So we can see how to judge. If you see the market went down, then the price sideways or go up. So this is the strong stocks. Then we can see here. This is the high point. This is another high point. This is the high point, another high point. So what's the difference? Firstly, let's see the market, the STI index. So we can see the high point is lower and lower, but the stocks, the high point is higher and higher. So which one is strong? The shares is stronger than index. So this is the good stocks, right? Okay, then we can see next one. This one is also strong. This is the new stocks. So how to judge this stock is strong? So we can see here, the price, the market, the index went down, right? But the stock went up. What's that mean? Stronger than index, right? So this stock is stronger than index. We'd better buy and keep the stocks, right? Okay, because if you know that this stock is stronger than index, in the future, the trend is good. The price, the share is strong, is good for you to catch. Okay, then we can see next one. This one is also strong, right? Okay, then we can see this one. Novel, strong or not? So we can see here, the price, we can judge the trend. The price go up, the share go up. The high point of the index is higher and higher, but the high point of the novel is lower. So stronger or not? It's not strong, right? So you'd better not buy these stocks because it's weaker than index. So if you buy this stock, you will lose money. Okay, then we can see this one. Then you can see the price drop, the market drop, the price drop. The market go up, the price still drop. But for now, it's good to buy or not. Okay, so we can see the this one, novel. For current price, whether it's good to buy or not. Okay, so we can see here, this is the low point, right? This is another low point. So if we see the price like this, the low point is lower and lower. So can we buy here or not? No, because we cannot confirm the trend is good or not. Okay, then we can see next one, the price drop again. So whether this is a low point or not, for now, can we recognize this is a low point? We cannot make it, we cannot confirm, right? Okay, then if this is the low point, what's the difference? This is the low point. If the another low point, so create the low point is higher than previous. What's that meaning? So option, right? Okay. So we see this stock. Just now I taught you the Hatcher law. What do you still remember? 10%. If the price rise around 10% from the bottom, so maybe the uptrend will be informed. We don't know whether the uptrend is for medium term or long term or short term, but we know that this is for the long term trend. Okay, so you can calculate this is the low price, right? 0.163. The next, the high price is 0.205. Rise around 10% or not? More than 10%, right? Okay, so this is the method. Then we can see next one.
Sorry, Jack. We have one method to show the change, right?
Yes. Yeah. So, okay. Then we want to... Okay, then this one. We can calculate Then you can click simple statistics from the low point to the high point. So you can see this is the turn, the natural days, the trading period, the turn rate, the variety is more than 10%. Okay, then we can see next one. Then we can see next, we can see so many stock. So this stock is strong or not? Yes, it's stronger, right? Because we can see the market go down, then the price in sideways, right? It's stronger than index. Okay, then we can see here. The market, the STI index dropped, but the price is in sideways. So it's stronger than index, okay? Then we can see this stock. Okay, then we can see this one. This one is strong or not? So we can see here, for this period, then we can see this strong or not. The market went down, the price strong rebound. Stronger than index or not? Yes, it's stronger, right? Okay, but you should know from this period. The market down, then the price in sideways, right? The market up, the price is still in sideways. So for now, it's stronger or not? No more stronger, right? Okay, then we can see next one. So we can see this stock. This stock is good or not? How to judge? Firstly, we can compare to the index, okay? So we can see here, the price, the market dropped. Then the price, this share sideways, right? The market went down, the share still in sideways. So good or not? Never move, okay? Then the price dropped, then sideways. The price go up, still in sideways. Okay, so let's see the chart of the stocks. Okay, then we can see this stock and we can see this one. This is the, we know this is a peak drop, okay? Then the price go up, then has some rebound. So from the volume, can you judge whether the bank money is still inside or not? Okay, then we can see this one. This is the price, then 1, 2, 3. We can calculate the low point to the high point. More than 10%, right? So we know that. Then the price drop and hits a new low or not? Not yet, okay? So this stock, there's no volume. If the volume can increase, maybe have chance to go up. So the volume is very important. So someday maybe you can see this stock is in its own high volume, is a high volume stock. Or maybe you can check the volume every day. If the volume starts to increase, so this stock is good, okay? Then you can use this method to judge. This is the chart comparison. We can use this method to judge whether this stock is strong or not, okay? So we can see this one. Then what's the price, the market sideways, right? But the price go up. So this one for now stronger than index, right? Okay, so this is the first one. First, the philosophy. Index first, stop next. The next one is long-term first, short-term next. Okay, so you can click chart period comparison. You can use this. Okay, you can use this one to judge the daily chart, to check the monthly chart, weekly chart, and daily chart to judge whether this stock is suitable for medium term or long term or short term. Okay, so this one, you just know it. Then we can see the next one, buy low, sell high. Buy low, the initial rising stage. Sell high, for a long time. Amplitude and reach wide. Conclusion, follow the market. We should follow the market. So how to sell, how to buy low, sell high. Last course, I already taught you this method. How to buy, how to set buy low, sell high point. Do you still remember? Do I need to repeat it again? No need, right? Okay, so you know how to set buy low, sell high signal. Then we can see next one. Who should you defeat? Okay, so we know that money can push the price up, right? And the money include the retailers like ours, then traders, bankers, country, institution investors, dealer, and listed company. Then who should you defeat? It's difficult, right? Okay, then we can see next one. Whom do you earn from the market? Story about friend and bear. The first one, no need to run faster than others, as long as faster than the people around you. You should remember. The next one, the purpose of learning is for learning, but learning to change. The essential purpose of learning is to change. Change your method, change your idea, change your thought. Okay. The next one, different with investors who always lose money. Okay. So this is story about friend and bear. Then we can see next one. Three axioms of technical analysis. The first one, market discounts everything. The next one, price follows the trend. The last one, history will repeat itself. Okay, so let's see the first viewpoint. Market discounts everything. The first one, price movements must reflect the relation between supply and the demand. The next one, price discounts everything of market. Price fluctuation, volume, the number of participants, as well as all factors which affect price movements. The next one, it is the basis of technical analysis. This is the market discounts everything. Okay, then we can see next one. The basic viewpoint of technical analysis. The various factors of supply and demand, including everyone's hope for future, worry, fear, and so on, which are all reflected in the stock price and the volume. So I think volume and price are both important for us, okay? Because all factors will reflect in the stock price and the volume. Then we can see the next one is price follow trend. Later I will show you how to use stocks, how to use software to judge this one. Okay, so the price follow trend. The first one, trend is the core of technical analysis. Price movement is not random, but regular. It has sustainable development once the trend is formed. The next one, the most important in stocks is following the previous trend. Okay. The trend is direction. Price movement is directional. The trend is the direction. The price will continue to go up in downtrend while the price will fall in the downtrend. Okay, so today we will learn three functions to judge the short-term, medium-term, and the long-term trend. How to use these three functions to judge. Okay, this in functions are all belong trend indicators. Okay, so the first one is called trend expert. Short-term trend indicator. This is for short-term. for the market rebound and the consolidation period. Okay, so this is the trend expert. So we can see the trend expert. If you want to use trend expert to judge your stocks, I think it's simple and easy because we can see they have the main line. The main line can help us to judge the trend. Main line, green and purple, for medium term trend. Okay, can help us to judge the medium term trend. The purple line is up, the trend is in the uptrend. The green line is down, the trend is downtrend. Okay, so we can see this stock. Firstly, we can see the main line, the direction of the main line. If you see the main line is up, this is the uptrend. Okay, so if you see the main line is down, the trend is in the downtrend. Okay, then Dow candlestick. We'd better buy and keep stocks in the uptrend. So the Dow candlesticks, short-term trend. Okay, this Dow candlesticks can help us to judge the short-term trend. Where is the buy point? Where is the sell point? Okay, red candlestick means the short-term uptrend. Green candlestick means the short-term downtrend. Okay, so how to use this method to judge? So we can see. Firstly, let's click the trend expert. Okay, so firstly, let's see the trend. The trend is, for medium term, is downtrend or uptrend? Downtrend, because the main line is green and down. So this is the downtrend. Okay, if you see the trend is in the downtrend. Okay, so we can see here. Then we can see the, this is the lines, right, the six lines. Then we can see here. This is, if we see the, this is Dow candlestick can help us to judge the short-term trend, right? Okay, if you see the green candlestick turn to the red candlestick, can we get in or not? Because we know that the trend is in the downtrend for medium term, right? Okay, for short term buy point, if we see the green Dow candlestick change to red Dow candlestick, can we buy or not? For short term, can we get in or not? We don't know. Okay, then I can teach you this method. If you see the Dow candlestick change to red candlestick, and you should see the six lines. At least three lines turn to purple. It's the good buy point for short term. But we can see here, green turn to the red candlestick. Can we buy or not? No, because only there's no lines turn to purple, right? So we cannot buy. We should wait and see. Okay, then green turn to the purple again. Can we buy or not? No, we'd better wait and see. Then we can see next one. Can we buy or not? Then we can see green turn to the red candlestick, but only two lines are purple, right? So it tells me, which means that we'd better wait and see, okay? Then, okay, then we see here. Can we buy at this point or not?
Yes.
Firstly, let's see the buy conditions. If you want to buy some stocks, you'd better check the buy conditions, whether it's suitable or not. Okay, then we can see this one. Green candlestick turn to the purple, turn to the red candlestick, and at least three lines turn to purple. Can we buy or not? We can buy for short term, okay? Then we can check the price. The price is 0.085. Okay, this is the close price. Then we can buy, then we keep. Can we sell or not? No. Then we can see that today's price is 0.095 money or not. Yes, right. Okay, then we can see next one. So we check some stocks. So for normal, can we get in or not? Okay, then we can see this one. Can we buy here or not? Only for shorter, okay? Because the first condition, we can see the main trend. The medium-term trend is downtrend. So we should control our position, cannot put some full position. Okay, green turn to the red candlestick. At least the three lines turn to purple. Can we buy for short term or not? Yes, buy for short term. The price is around 0.176. This is the price. Then we can see keep or not. We should sell. Because if you see the trend is in the downtrend, you must sell. Once the red candlestick turn to the green candlestick, you must sell because this is the downtrend. You'd better sell quickly, okay? So if you buy here, then you sell at this price, 0.184, a money or not. Also can a money, right? Okay, then we can see next one.
Oh, what can I buy the price?
You can move to here, then you can check the price.
Where?
Okay. Then we can see next one.
Where?
This stock. Okay, then we can see this stock. Then we see here, this is the price, right? So we can see this price is here. Can we get in or not? So we can check the trend. Firstly, we see the main line. It's down, right? So the medium term uptrend or downtrend? Downtrend, right? Okay, let me see here. Green turn to the red, and at least three lines turn to purple. Can we buy or not? For short term, can we get in or not?
Yeah.
Then if we buy, then the price is 0.118, then we can keep, sell or not, just keep it, sell or not, still can keep, right, you still can keep. If you buy at this price, you still keep it, a money or not. Actually, this method is simple, right? Yes. Today I didn't talk about volume, because yes, we can check the volume. If you see the green turn to the purple and volume increase, it's better, okay? Then we can see next one. This stock. So we see here. Firstly, let's see the trend is good or not. It's in sideways, right? Why? Because we can see the line is flat. So it tells me, which means that this is the sideways area. Okay, then we can see the candlestick like this. Can we buy or not? Firstly, let's see the green turn to the red candlestick. At least the three lines turn to purple. Can we buy or not? Yes, this is the buy point. If you want to catch some short-term profit, you can buy. Then you still keep it. This is the buy price. This is the current price. You also can make money, right? Okay, then we can see this stock. This stock is CNMC, okay? Then we can see this one. Firstly, let's check the medium-term trend. Medium-term trend is uptrend or downtrend? It's uptrend, right? Okay, then if you see the trend is in the uptrend, we'd better find some good buy point. This is the buy point or not? Yes, this is another buy point, right? Green turn to the red candlestick. Then we can see this one. Today, the price turn to green candlestick. So can we buy or not for short term? If you see the green turn to the red, you can buy again. Okay, because the main trend is still in the uptrend. Okay, so if you see the green turn to the red, you'd better buy again. Because, you know, this method is simple. actually is simple, right? But if you think this method is simple, maybe you will not use it. Then you will lose some opportunity, right? Okay, so we can see next one. This dog. This dog is good or not? Okay, so firstly, let's see here. Can we buy at the store? Can we buy this dog at this price? Yes, right. Because the buy conditions are all satisfied. Okay, then if we buy. If you didn't buy here, can we buy here again? Yes, green turn to the purple, then a green turn to the red candlestick, we can buy again, okay? So you can use this simple method. Let's see this one, OGKE. This stock is went up strongly, right? Okay, then we can see here is the buy point. Here can we buy or not? Yes, for shorter. Then you can see today, the price sharply up, right? Okay, so maybe you think here if I see, then you should buy another day at open price. Okay, so the open price is 0.103. okay, so you can use this method to catch some shorter profit, but you should know this method is only for short, is mainly for short-term investment. Okay, so this is the method. Then we can see next one. This is the downtrend, right? If you see the green line is down. This is the downtrend. Then if you see the share is in the uptrend, when you see the green turn to the red, 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 are all the buy point, okay? Then this is the method for short term. If you want to catch some short term profit, you can use Trend Expert. Maybe this method is simple, but I think the simple is best. Okay, simple is best. Then we can see next one, trend indicators. Medium trend indicator for the market is weekly uptrend. For medium term, not for short term, okay? If you want to catch some medium term uptrend, medium term profit, you can use this function to judge. This function is called homely position. Okay, homely position. Then we can see they also have the main line. Yeah, main line. Main line is green line, stands for the long term trend, okay? The main line is up, the long term is uptrend. Main line is down, the long-term trend is downtrend, okay? Then we can see next one, increase safe buy point. So if we see the increase point appears, this is the safe buy point. Okay, the stop loss point is the sell point. If you see the stop loss, this is the sell point. Okay, the increase position, get support of yellow line. If you see the price drop, uptrend, then drop to yellow line, then get some support. This is another increase position. But if you see the decrease position, the price fall below the yellow line, you'd better decrease your position, okay? So I teach you how to use this method to catch some medium-term profit, okay? So firstly, we should click homely position. Okay, then we can see this one. We can see this stock. Okay, so how to use this function. So firstly, let's see the main trend. The long-term trend is downtrend or uptrend? Downtrend, right? Okay, then the long-term trend is downtrend. Then we can see the candlestick. One bullish candlestick, upward breakthrough, upward cross, white line and yellow line. And the white line and the yellow line go up. This is the first buy point. First buy point, okay? Then you wait and see. The increase signal appears. This is because here you can find some position, maybe one third position or one fourth position. Okay? Then if you see the increase signal appears, this is the second buy point. So this is not the first buy point. This is the first buy point. This is the second buy point. Okay? So the second buy point, then we can wait and see. Then you can see the price start to drop, right? Drop to and drop and fall into the band. Okay? The band. So this is the third buy point. Because we can see the green line, the long-term trend is uptrend, right? So this is the third buy point. Then we can see the next one. Then you can keep your stocks, okay? Stop loss point appears. What's that meaning? Sell or not? Two situations. The first one, if you see the green line is still up, so if the stop loss point appears, decrease position. Okay, no need to sell out. Decrease your position because the long-term trend is good. Okay, then we can see next one. Because the green line is still flat, right? Okay, not go, not down. Then you can wait. Then increase appear again. What's that meaning? You still can increase your position. Okay, then you can hold your stocks. Then the price fell into the band and touch the yellow line, get some support. Can we buy here again or not? This is the next buy point. Then we can buy and keep our stocks. Then still can keep. Whether can buy now or not. Then we can see, firstly, let's see the long-term trend. Is up or not? Is up or down? It's uptrend, right? So no need to worry if you want to keep for medium, if you want to keep for long term. No need to worry. Okay? Then we can see here. The price is here. So we know that this is the, and we can see the yellow line and the white line still up, right? So it tells us that the trend is good. So no need to worry. Okay, because you have another chance to buy again. Then we can see next one. Can see some strong stocks. Whether have some stocks or not. Okay, so if we take this stock as an example. So here, can we regard this point as the buy point? No. Why? We should know the reason. This is a bullish candlestick, but never upward cross the two lines, right? So we need to wait and see. Then we can see next one. Can we buy or not here? We see the candles, the price, the candlestick, the price like this. Can we buy or not? Because we don't know the future trend. So if you need to make decision at this point, can we buy again or not? Wait and see, right? Because the volume decrease or increase? Decrease. Okay. Then you wait. Can we buy or not? The increase signal appears and the candlestick upward cross the three lines, upward cross the two lines. So can we buy or not here? Yes, it is the buy point and the volume increase, okay? Then we buy at this price because we only see today, right? Then we can buy tomorrow, then we still can earn some profit, right? Okay, so where is the next buy point? If you didn't buy this stock, which point is the good buy, another buy point? If you see the price has some cracked and fell into the band, and the green light still up, you can have another chance to buy. Because if you didn't buy this stock, you should find a good opportunity to get in. Okay, so we can see next one. This stock, Yoma. Yoma is good or not? Yes, it's good, right? Okay, then we can see here, the price like this. Can we buy or not? So let's see the buy conditions. The bullish candlestick upward cross the yellow and white line. So, and the white line and the yellow line go up. So can we buy here or not? Volume increase, can we buy or not? Yes, this is the first buy point, okay? Then if you see the increase point appears, this is the second buy point, okay? So if you buy here, here you didn't get in, you didn't increase open some position. So if you buy here, a little high, right? So here is the first buy point. The increase is the second buy point. Then we can wait and see. The price drop to the band. Can we buy again or not? So we see here, should we sell or not? Then we can see the green line still upright. So means still uptrend, no need to sell, just keep it, right? Then you can catch some opportunity. Then we can see next one. This one today sharply upright. Okay, so this one is good or not? So firstly, let's see this period. Can we buy at this price or not? Okay, firstly, let's see this one. The price, the volume increase, okay? Then the price, the bullish candlestick, and the white line and yellow line can go up. Can we buy here or not? If you agree this is the buy point, you can fence your hands up. No, this is not a good buy point because the candlestick didn't upward cross the two lines. So cannot buy, okay? You should wait and see. Then we can see another day. Can we buy here or not? The volume increase and the bullish candlestick upward cross the white line and yellow line. And white line and yellow line are go up. So this is the good buy point, okay? Then if we buy, this is increased position. Then we keep, okay? Keep and see. Then you can earn some profit, right? Okay. Then we see here. Can we buy or not? Because this is today's price. So can we buy or not?
Yeah.
Firstly, let's see the long-term trend. The green light go up or go down?
No.
Go down, right? The trend is good or not? Not good. But we can see here, the volume increase. The candlestick upward cross the two line and the two line go up. Buy or not? You can buy, but you should control your position, maybe one third position, okay? So if you see the candlestick like this, which price is the good buy point? Just now I taught you this method, do you still remember? Half of the candlestick, right? This is, I checked the so many Singapore stocks. This method is very, the accuracy is high. Okay, half of, if you know this stock, right? You already focus on this stock. Half of the candlestick is the good buy price. I think the price, this stock maybe has another short-term profit, okay? Then you can use this method to judge, to catch some medium-term uptrend, medium-term profit, okay? So this one, Parkson, okay. This one is good. Then we can see next one. Trend indicator, this one is called homely rainbow. This one is a little complicated. Okay, so homely rainbow, the boundary of bull and bear market. This is the long-term trend indicator for the confirmation of bull and bear market. So we can see they have so many lines, right? The white lines represents the long-term trend. The blue line stands for medium long-term trend. The yellow line means the medium-term trend. The red line represents the short-term trend, okay? So if you want to check the share whether suitable for long-term trend or medium-long-term trend or short-term trend, you can use the lines to judge. Okay, so let's see this stock. This stock is China Aviation. China Aviation is so strong, right? Okay, if you keep this stock, you will be happy because it can help you to make a great profit. Okay, then we can see this stock. Firstly, let's see the white line. The white line from down to flat, right? Okay, means the long-term trend is flat, is sideways. Okay, the blue line stands for the medium long-term trend. We can see the blue line go up, so the medium long-term trend is good. The yellow line, medium long-term trend. If you see the yellow line go up or go up for medium long-term trend, it's very good. The red line stands for short-term trend. Okay, if you see the red line or go up, the short-term trend is also good, right? Okay, so we can see this one. Let's see this stock. We can find this information, find this function. Okay, so this one. From the long-term trend, the share is good or not? Long-term is not good. Just now we talked about the short-term, right? This share is good for short-term. Okay, then if you buy this stock, where is the resistance? White line, right? Okay, then we can see next one. Let's see this stock. This stock is good or not? Okay, for we can see the yellow line, green line, and the red line. From down to flat, what's that meaning? The trend start to change, right? But for long term, still in the downtrend, right? But for the medium term or short term, the trend will be changed, okay? Then we can see the price just upward break through the yellow line, okay? So you can make decision, right? Then we can see next one. So we can see this stock. Os Group. The Os Group. So we can see here, this is the big bullish candlestick on high volume, right? So which price is the good buy point? Half, right? So here is the half of the price. Then we can wait and see. Then just touch half of the candlestick, right? But whether this stock can go up or not, we'd better check by the volume, right? If the volume can go up, can increase, this is the good buy point, right? So you can check, you can catch some short-term profit. Then we can see next one. This one is strong, Thai Bridge. I also posted this stock on my Facebook. I don't know whether you catch or not, you follow or not. I posted this share around this period. Then we can see this stock. Let's see this one. The white line gathering, right, but still down. The blue lines go down. Then the yellow lines gathering, right? gathering and the flat. So good or not? If you see the yellow line are all gathering, which means that you should pay more attention because the price, the share can need to maybe may reverse, okay? So we see here, if you see the price can upward breakthrough, if you see the yellow line go up from down to flat and go up again, it's the good chance, okay? So for medium term, it's the good chance. Then here, the price upward breakthrough the white line, which was that meaning? Birth of the horse, dark horse, right? Birth of the dark horse, then you can know that this is the good shares, right? Okay, so we can check some stocks. So this one is good or not? My portrait, this one is so strong, right? Okay, then we can see here, if you want to catch some short-term profit or long-term profit. Okay, so we can see this stock. For the medium long-term, good or not? Good, but short-term has some correction. But for medium long-term, it's good. Because we see here, the price just touch the support of yellow line, then go up again. Maybe have a chance to go. Then you can earn some good profit, right? So recently we know that there are so many strong stocks in Singapore market. So we can catch some good opportunity, right? Okay, then we can see next one. Because just now we learned three functions. Will the do you still remember? I'm not sure. Chain expert suitable for short-term chain, right? And homely position for medium term. Then homely rainbow, mostly for long term. Okay. So but you can use homely rainbow to check the trend, check the market trend. If you see the trend is in the downtrend, you can use chain expert or homely position or homely rainbow to judge where is the buy and sell point. Okay, then we can check another one. You can see some stocks, then I need to know whether you can understand or not. Okay, then we can see this one. This one is good or not. Then we can check this stock. Okay, so firstly, let's see the overall trend. The main trend, the long-term trend is downtrend, right? The medium long-term trend is downtrend. But for the yellow line, the medium trend, from down to flat, and the lines are all gathering. What's that meaning? The trend may reversal, right? But we don't know. Okay, then we can draw the line. This is the first one. Okay, then we can see this stock. Good or not?
No.
Okay, so which pattern? Triangle pattern, right? So bottom triangle pattern or top triangle pattern? The bottom right. Okay, then we can see this stock. The price just upper breaks through the triangle pattern. The volume increase, right? So good or not? For shorter. Okay. So maybe you have a chance to know that recently so many stocks are start to go up, then you can put these stocks into your favorite and focus on the trend, the price trend, and find some good opportunity to get in. Okay, then if the price can upward break through the white line, the next resistance is white line. Okay, then this is the stocks. Okay, then we can see this. This one is also good. So we can see so many stocks, right? Okay, so every day you can check your stocks. I don't know whether you grasp this the method which I mentioned at the beginning of the class. Okay, so how to find some strong stocks? You can use this method. Firstly, you should click sector browse, right? And extract. Then we can find some high. Then we can click this one. Because you want to know in this month which stocks are strong, then you can use this method to find. Okay, we can right click percentage and click this one. So we can see this one is good or not. Which pattern? If you use Homing Rainbow to judge, okay, then we can see this one. The price just the upward breakthrough. What's the difference? The price just upward breaks through the white line, right? And the white line, the yellow line, and the blue line are all. The white line still go down, right? But the medium short term is good, okay? So you can see next one. This one we can see. Also, upward breaks through the white line, right? Okay, so we can see next one. This one is upward breakthrough, then we can see this one. Already upward breakthrough, right? Okay, so you can see so many stocks. Then if you want to find some strong stocks, you can use this method to catch, okay? Then, this is the Omni Rainbow, okay? Then, let's remember the important point of today's course, okay? Today we talk about the preview of technical analysis. This is the first course of technical analysis, okay? Then we can see this is the STI monthly chart. We should know 10 years trend probability of statistic of STI. So we know that July, if you know this, if you remember this chart, you know July, the market is good, you can buy some stocks, right? Okay, then we can see next one, the support and resistance of STI weekly chart. Then this is the main contents. Today we learned the fundamental analysis and the technical analysis and why we use technical analysis to judge our stocks. Then we know what's the wrong investment sort of investors. If we know this, we'd better change our investment sort. Then this is the hot law, okay? Then generally, right? Not the all stocks are satisfied, okay? Just you should remember this one, okay? So if the generally the downtrend will be formed when the price drop around 10% from the top. However, the uptrend will be formed when the price rise around 10% from the bottom. Then you should establish the correct investment philosophy. The index first, the stock next. We should follow the market. Long term first, the short term next. Okay, to analyze our stocks and how to judge whether this stock is stronger than index or not. Then this is the story. Okay, the next one is the axiom of technical analysis. Market discounts everything. This is the basic viewpoint of technical analysis. Price will follow trend. History will repeat itself. Then we talked about market discount everything. The basic viewpoint of technical analysis, price follow trend. Trend is direction. And in the end of the class, then at the end of the class, we talk about the trend indicators, right? Because we learn this technical analysis and we need to use 10 trend indicators to judge the buy and sell point. The first one is for short-term trend indicator for the market rebound and the consolidation period. This function is called trend expert. The main line, how to use Dow candlestick to catch but to judge the buy and sell point. Then the next one is holding position, the medium-term trend indicator for the market's weekly chart, weekly uptrend. Okay, so we know the main trend and the increase stop loss, increase position, decrease position, and how to find how to catch four buy points through this function, holding position. I don't know whether you can remember or not. Maybe next time you, when you attend the next class, you will forget everything, right? But I hope you can review it at home. You cannot attend one seminar because you spend your time, right? So if you spend your time to attend the seminar and you cannot remember anything, it's not deserved, right? It's not worthy. Then we can see this one. This is the homely rainbow, the long-term trend indicator for the confirmation of bull and bear market. Okay, so homely rainbow, you should know how to use homely rainbow to find the to judge whether it's good or not. We can know the trend, the long-term trend, medium long-term trend, and the short-term trend. Okay, so this is the next one. History will repeat itself. This is the last one. It will have occurred, happen again. History will repeat itself, not only tell us to respect the trend, but also believe trend devoted, even if investors has been injured by trend, right? But even if you has been injured, you also need to believe trend devotedly, because trend is very important for us. So this is the fifth one, is four factors of technical analysis. The technical analysis include the price, volume, time, and space. Okay, so we know that the cornerstone, the tour, the bull and the bear, the reverse, the cost, the statistics, time, and space. Okay, so the price, volume, time, and space. This one, this is the four factors. All indicators are based on the price, volume, time, and space, the four factors. Okay, then we can see this one, price change, pattern change. This is for the, belongs to price. The next one, market behavior, belongs to volume, because market behavior can be reflected by the volume. Okay, volume can reflect the market behavior. The next one, timing of turning point, belongs to time. Then space of market, up and down space. Okay, so this is the four factors of technical analysis, and I hope every member can grasp the basic knowledge of technical analysis. And I also hope today's course can improve your methods. Okay, so thank you for attending today's class. Thank you so much.